Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video series deals with working on various CGI render passes in Autodesk Smoke. In the previous section, we used a motion vector pass supplied from Autodesk Maya to apply post-motion blur to our CGI robot. Let's look at a different situation where you have been supplied with the CGI element, but no motion vector has been supplied for the motion blurring. In this case, we can use Smoke to do a motion analysis to produce a motion vector pass. Please be aware that this is not 100% bulletproof, but it might be very useful in most situations. Once again, in the default library, go to the Shot1 folder. Hold Command and click on the Beauty Ball Render Pass and the Matte Ball Render Pass. Drag the selection into the ConnectiveX schematic near the robot CGI elements. Press the Effects Node button to toggle to the ConnectiveX node bin. Hover over the node bin and press M to bring up Motion Analysis. Drag out the Motion Analysis node and place it in front of the Beauty Ball Render Pass. Connect the Render Pass into the input of the Motion Analysis node. Please note that the Motion Analysis node only works with 16-bit data, since it will produce a 16-bit motion vector pass. If you are on the first frame, you won't see anything because the ball is not moving. Scrub forward to the middle of the shot and you will see the motion vectors being generated. Double-click on the Motion Analysis node just to have a peek at its controls. Motion analysis uses optical flow or motion estimation to work out the motion vectors of the football. The only setting you can adjust is the resolution of the analysis. A quarter resolution is not a pixel quality like draft or preview. It is the quality of analysis to determine the motion blur. Full resolution is slower, but it will take into account every pixel movement. A quarter resolution is faster, but it takes into account groups of pixels rather than individual pixels. Each one will yield different results, but a quarter resolution is normally adequate for most situations. So now we have our motion vector pass, we can now apply motion blur to the football. Press the Effects Node button to return to the ConnectiveX nodes. Hover over the node bin and press M for the Motion Blur node. Drag the Motion Blur node out of the node bin and place it in front of the Motion Analysis node. As with the robot passes, connect the Beauty Pass into the red front input. Connect the Motion Analysis output into the grey vector input. And finally, connect the Alpha Pass into the blue matte input of the Motion Blur node. Double-click on the Motion Blur node to bring up its controls. Set the blur amount to 0.5. The football now has motion blur applied to it in the Beauty Pass. Set the vector softness to 0.2 to smooth any artifacts caused by the motion blur. You can also add additional post blur to the motion blur to help with any artifacts missed by the vector smoothing. Set the post blur to 0.5. Finally, let's look at the alpha channel. Hover over the result view and press F4 to toggle to the outmat view. There are no gaps in the alpha, so there is no need to adjust the matte fill. Hover over the view and toggle F4 again to go back to the result view. As I said, trying to analyze the motion of a moving object may not always work, but when it does, the results are pretty acceptable. So now we have both our CGI elements with their motion blur, and they are ready to be composited. In the next video, we will combine all the separate elements together and composite them over the video background. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.